Oh, yeah, so I already showed you poly, or I talked about it, yeah. So if I say, what's the characteristic polynomial K? By the way, I don't know if you noticed, it took some time. This is only a 2x2 matrix, and it took a little bit of work. Well, let me do poly of F just for fun. Let's watch and see. I guess it's pretty quick. What does that mean? Just so you guys understand. So let's see if we can translate what it just spit out. See, because imagine you're going to find the eigenvalues of F by hand. So there's matrix F. That's the one I skipped. Remember that one? So how would you do it? Well, F is this matrix. It's all ones, but then there's twos down the diagonal. The way I created it was I made a matrix full of ones, and then I added an identity to it, turned them into two. Can I do that? So if I wanted to find the eigenvalues of this F, by hand, what would I do? Well, I'd start off by saying, I need the determinant of what? F minus lambda I. And so that's the determinant of 2 minus lambda 1, 1, 1, 1, 2 minus lambda 1, 1. 1, 1, 2 minus lambda, 1. There it is. I hope you guys understand, that's not easy to compute. Have you ever done determinant of a 4x4 matrix? You have? Where? In high school. Okay. This is not fun to do this. And so I'm glad the calculator did it for me. We will read about determinants for next time. And by the way, did you guys notice, I don't want you to read the whole section on determinants. It's too much. Okay? Marla did it all already?
Yeah.
Good for her. It would make me sick. Actually, there's some really good stuff in what we're going to skip. But
just...
power stuff. Yeah, that's the most explicit. Yeah, that will do. That's section 4. It's mentioned in 3, yeah. But I mentioned it today, too. I said up until, I mentioned a theorem number. There's some really cool ideas. No, don't do Cramer's rule. Cramer's rule is great, but don't do it. Yeah, stop before Cramer's. I just feel that a little too much time is spent on determinants in general. Because why? Look, I had a 4x4 matrix. I'm already going to have a tough time computing this determinant. I'll show you guys how next time probably. Okay. But anyway, if you computed it, what would it equal? It would equal this. Where did the crazy Freeman go? There we go. It would equal... So how do I translate that? That's what I was trying to get at. So that 1, negative 8, let me ask you this. What degree will the polynomial be? 4. So this means, when it puts that out, it means that the characteristic polynomial is lambda to the 4th minus 8 lambda cubed plus 18 lambda squared minus 16 lambda plus 5. Can't solve what? Maybe, right? Actually, it's a good college algebra problem. It's find values of lambda that make this equal to what? 0. Because what you have to do is set that equal to 0. Do you guys know how to solve an equation like that? Oh, right. Yeah. If I was nice and I knew.
Slammed at 1 in 5. So
1 in 5, yeah. 1 in 5 are good guesses, and -1 and -5. Because, and actually, 1 is easy to test. Let's throw in lambda equals 1 and see if it works. Does it work? Well, you get 19 plus 5 is 24. Minus, do you see it? Lambda equals 1 is one of the solutions. And once you know lambda equals 1, but all of a sudden, this is turning into college algebra class, right? And then you factor out lambda minus 1, and yeah, that's good progress. What do I want to do now? Well, one thing I want to do is I want to make sure I show you another nice command. Check this one out. Eig. How about this? Eig. E-I-G of F. You know what that does? Gives me the eigenvalue.
1115.
Why did it do 1115? What do you think that means? It means that this thing factors, one thing it means, into what? Yep. Lambda minus 1 cubed times lambda minus 5. And you can actually, this is like that talk on Friday. It's easy to go the other way, right? You could check that if you multiply this all out, you get that huge polynomial. Okay? So that's kind of mean. So we would say that the algebraic multiplicity of 1 is what? 3. And the algebraic multiplicity of 5 is 1. What about the geometric multiplicity? Not bad. We have a little bit of work to do, right? Okay. So once I somehow am able to do this. Right. So let me show you what to do. I have the eigenvalues, right? These are the eigenvalues. So now what do? I want to find what? Oh, yeah. Okay, the geometric multiplicity. I want to find... the associated eigenvectors. And since they form a subspace, EVs I've been calling those, find the associated eigenvectors. And what I'm going to say is, let's find a basis for... If I write this, do you guys know what this means? This was a discovery exercise. Oh, I'm lucky. Look what they did. They gave me V1, V2, and V3. It says, show that those are all fixed vectors. So, you didn't have to find them if you did the discovery exercise. They told you. So those are all the eigenvectors that are associated with 1. By the way, part B, do you guys understand this one? What do you think that is? What would happen if you did F times... What if you did that transpose, so it really looks like this, right? What would happen if I did F times V4, what would I get? Well, I'd get a 4 by 1. What would the first row be? What would the first number be? 5. It's going to be 2 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. Right? So this would be a 5. Then what? They'd all be 5s, right? And what does that mean? vector because it's 5 times 1, 1, 1. All right? So actually, now I know. Now I know something. I know that this, if I wanted a basis for E5, what would it be? It would be, for example, you could use 1, 1, 1, 1. How do I know it's one-dimensional? Well, because the algebraic multiplicity is one-dimensional. And the geometric multiplicity has to be less than or equal to. So it's got to be one-dimensional. Does that make sense? So, to get a basis for E1, and by the way, I didn't really get the basis for this. I just kind of showed you that we already had it. You would do this the same way. But let me show you how you find the basis for E1. What you do is you write down your equation again. And my equation would be F minus 1. That's my lambda, right? It's F minus lambda I times V has to be the zero vector. So F minus 1I times V has to be the zero vector. And by the way, what is the matrix F minus 1I? What is that matrix? It's all 1. That's right. Times, let me write V1, V2, V3, V4, okay? And it has to be 4, 0, that's right. Not yet, that's not, but I'm getting there. I'm finding it. You guys with me? Do you understand where this matrix equation came from? You do? By the way, what if I wanted to write it as an augmented matrix? Well, it would look like this. Right? Because this is how you solve it, right? And then what do you do? How do you solve that system of equations? What? There will always be infinitely many solutions when you're looking for eigenvectors. Yeah. But if we do the row operation, what would it look like? Well, couldn't you eliminate every row except for the first one? What does that mean? Pluses, but yeah. V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus V4 equals 0. True. So let me go a little slower for a second. And let me say, what did I just learn here? What's the rank of this matrix, this F minus 1i? It's rank 1. But n is 4. And what does that mean? Three free variables. Dun, dun, dun. It also means that the nullity, that was the word we had for it, of the matrix with all the ones is equal to 3. And that means that the dimension of the eigenspace is going to be 3. Okay? Because if you think about what I'm going to write, I'm going to write, now what am I going to use for my three variables? How about R, S, and T? V1 plus R plus S plus T equals 0. Is that okay? So like Rita said, we can put all those on the other side. V1 equals minus R minus S minus T. And so let me show you what these things look like. eigen vectors in E1 look like this. Negative R minus S minus T, R, S, and T. They look like that. And now, I'm going to split it up. I'm going to write it as R times negative 1, 1, 0, 0, plus F times negative 1, 0, 1, 0, right? Plus T times negative 1, 0, 0, 1, right? And so we finish and we say a basis for E1 is given by what? Well, these three vectors. Negative 1, 1, 0, 0. Negative 1, 0, 1, 0. And negative 1, 0, 0, 1. Get that? Good.
E1
is the span of those three vectors. Okay. So if you take any vector, take 2 times the first one, 1 times the second one, and negative 3 times the third one, add that all together, you'll get another eigenvector, right? There's a lot of eigenvectors. Go back to screen that and do a little bit. What should I show you guys? Oh, I know. Here is F. And I mentioned this command called eig. Let me show you another command. I think it's the same command, actually. V, comma, E. Like this. Equals eig of F. I want to explain what this is going to do. See, if I just write eig of f, it spits out the eigenvalue. But now I'm telling it, give me more output. What it's going to do, it's going to give me a matrix V, which has the eigenvalue. But it's also going to give me a matrix E, which has what? The eigenvectors. Watch. This is really cool. Oh, no, it did it the other way. V is the eigenvectors, and E is the eigenvalues. Break down the diagonal of the matrix. You guys see that? So let me, for example, do this. Let me take, and you might say, why did it do what it did? V1, I'm going to define that to be V, row I don't care, so I put a colon, comma, and column 1. And so that should be the first column, right? Yeah, that's the first column of V. And now I can test it. I can say F times V1. And what should that give me? These columns are supposedly eigenvectors of what? Of F. Which means if I do F times V1, it should give me lambda times V1. And what's the lambda that I'm talking about? 1. So it worked. It gave me itself back. Now that's weird. If you look at what we have, do they have the same eigenvectors that I have? No. They have a different basis for those. Okay? What about their fourth eigenvector? One half, one half, one half, one half. Is that the same as what I had for E5? What did I have for E5? 1, 1, 1, 1. Right? So it's really the same. It's just a scalar multiple of it. But they definitely had a different basis for their eigenvectors than I did. And that's because they found them differently. Okay. They didn't do exactly what we did. But that's okay. You can still the same subspace. Still a three-dimensional subspace of R4. And a one-dimensional subspace of R4.